On your mark, ready, set, let's go.
Yeah, baby.
On your mark, ready, set, let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen,
it's time to swing, baby. Yeah.
Get into you with it.
Ladies and gentlemen,
it's freedom, baby.
Moisture that is transferred from the tropical Pacific.
And the two groups I mentioned, one Lamont, one here.
1,000 floats that cover every ocean basin.
They can blame it on El Nino, whatever it may be. Blame it on El Nino, and let your wife be falling in. And when you're away, blame it on El Nino, and hit the icebox for a treat. And if you watch
Thursday, the El Nino Watch, and a breakthrough in weather prediction, a weather satellite that sees right into a storm.
And it's those incredible winds that makes a cyclone so powerful.
This huge atmospheric turmoil living there got out safely. Atlanta that day was hit by a blitzkrieg, and that's when the trouble starts. That's a tornado. Tornadoes look like they're destroying, crashing through it at a rate of 10 feet a second. But what could anybody have done about a storm as bad as this? The answer has remained the same throughout time. The rain, the second weapon in a hurricane's armory, that can also do huge damage. These
temperatures. But what is El Nino, and how does it happen? Firstly, we need to know what's normally happening in the tropical Pacific. This vast stretch of this part of the world sits in a self-perpetuating state until El Nino begins. If conditions are right, tropical Pacific weather systems. It's this change in winds which has a knock-on effect, changing temperature and rainfall in locations around the world. The main impact, there's another impact from El Nino which happens because of all the extra heat at the surface of the tropical Pacific. This releases vast amounts of energy into the atmosphere, peaks around Christmas time and lasts for several months. It can die back to neutral conditions, but sometimes reverses into La Niña.
I am El Nino!
Oh, there it goes!
Complex weather patterns. South American fishermen in the 19th century describing warmer travels westward is now moving toward the east. Moisture then rises into the air and the visible repercussions are felt on land. In the western United waters, in 1997 and 98, the world experienced the biggest El Nino. Scientists are now better able to predict if and when.
Right. Here's how it works. During normal conditions, trade winds, which blow from east to west, push warm the warmer ocean fuels an intensification and southward shift of the jet stream. This brings flooding to the southern U.S. They blow the warm water back into the western Pacific and restart the upwelling of cool water towards the surface in the eastern, usually cold conditions in the tropical Pacific that displace the jet stream northward. La Niña can lead to drought in the southern. La Niña together are part of a cycle that influences extreme weather and can impact food production, water.
In California and Peru killed dozens and left thousands homeless. Kenya's annual rainfall was 40 inches above normal. And on the other side of the...
Steve Newman. Steve, I gather California's had a break now for a little over a day, but another storm coming on the...
And this cluster of thunderstorms and clouds and moisture actually went north of the equator right up...
And actually find out exactly what schools they're from when we get down to the bottom and talk to them.
Because they're such good sports, because this isn't...
Changing waters. Be careful when she comes down. There'll be a big splash when she hits some water.
Can you...
The storm is finally letting up here in the Bay Area, but it is still pounding the Sierra. We'll have a live...
Threatened is a $5 million house in the hills, but the land has already buckled up some 6 feet. The homeowner, at his own expense, is trying to excavate around...
Above one, East Bay City is still moving tonight. Geologists say there is a threat from a slow-moving landslide above the city of Fremont. Tonight, there was a town hall-type meeting.
And I feel really sorry for the people up there, and I hope we are too far away from it, but it's a concern for everybody in this neighborhood, I would say.
...indicated by underground water. They also believe that more rain can only mean more trouble, and that this slide could continue moving until summer.
...to Peru noticed warmer water usually appeared around Christmas in the southeastern United States, and drier weather in Indonesia and Australia. It also increases hurricane for both countries, action of water and wind in the Pacific Ocean, and thus the amount of water in the ocean, warm water on the Asian coasts. That leaves the deeper, colder water to backfill on the west. Water raining down on the Americas has to come from somewhere, right? Thus, 70 buoys strategically placed around the oceans.
Lots of girls and lots of boys, lots of smells and lots of...
Chain of events known as El Niño.
Sloshes back towards the central and eastern Pacific. Where the warm water is where you get your evaporative.
Redistribution of mass results in flows, which is what we call currents. But the redistribution of mass associated with...
And now, popular culture presents What's In and What's Out.
Your mark, ready, set, let's go.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah.
On your mark, ready, set, let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Yeah.